The whole thing started after watching a Netflix documentary about contaminated veggies. Naturally, I freaked out and placed an order of PVC pipes, lightings, and seeds, all to start one of those cool hydroponic gardens, where you can grow plants without soil, just water. I eagerly started my first batch, imagining a future of endless, healthy, organic, homegrown salad. But then I hit a snag. Tracking everything proved to be more complex than expected. Each plant, each growth stage, it was a lot to manage. To solve this tracking issue, maybe spending 10 minutes in Excel would be enough. Well, that's boring. I'd rather spend 50 hours developing an app that no one needs. But I'll do it anyway. But first, we need to determine the app's feature without overcomplicating things. To start, my germination tray is organized into a grid of 6x7, which amounts to 42 slots. Now let's talk nerdy. These 42 slots basically translate into a two-dimensional array, each slot with a unique X and Y position. As far as the hydroponic system, I'll keep it simple and follow the same structure. The app itself should enable users to manage their plant types, stages, and to register harvest date. That way we can collect enough data and maybe add a forecasting in the future. For the development, I'll be using Django for the backend and also to control views and HTML templates. For the database, we'll go with good old Postgres. Since I'll not be using React, the UI interactions might be a little bit tricky, but let's dance. Okay, the backend is pretty much good to go. After making a few changes, I realized that two of my classes are identical. And I know that's pretty bad, but at this point, I don't feel like running new migrations, so we'll keep it like that for now. The rest of the models control the plant info and the plant instance that has additional fields and constraints. After that, we have the views to connect query sets, forms, HTML templates, and so on. And as expected, not using React created some additional challenges, specifically when updating the X and Y position of an existing plant. Nothing crazy though, I got it fixed with some random JavaScript from Stack Overflow. But first, let me explain. If a plant instance is either in a germination stage, meaning in a germination tray, or growing, meaning in a hydroponic system, sometimes you might need to move the plant if the plant is not getting enough light, or whatever the reason might be. So we need to add some logic to handle these type of events. With that, we first need to visualize where the plant instance is currently located, and if we decide to move the plant, the new position must be empty. Now we need to wrap up the UI and see where and how to deploy this thing. Alright, let's get the localhost up and running, open the quote-unquote minimalistic landing page so we can log in and start using the application. Once we log in, we should be able to add a new plant type, so let's add a tomato. Next, we have to create a germination tray. For this example, let's do a smaller one, just a 5x5. If we open the tray we just created, we can start adding new plant objects to whatever X and Y position we choose. After that, we have to create a hydroponic system so we can transfer the plants once the germination stage is complete. For this example, we will create a system with 4 rows and 9 columns. That looks pretty good. Now we can access the germination tray. Once we select a plant, we can move it to a new position within the same tray, or we can transfer the plant to the hydroponic system we just created. When we transfer a plant from a germination tray to a hydroponic system, the stage gets automatically updated from germinating to growing. Also, the relation between the plant and the germination tray is removed, and a new relation between the plant and the hydroponic system is created with a respective X and Y position. Lastly, when it's time, we can access what we have growing in the hydroponic system and update the stage from growing to crop. Once we do that, the plant will be removed from the hydroponic system and moved to the archive. Okay, that was a lot of thinking and typing. If you made it this far, then you get a gold star. I gotta go, so bye now.